So in this tutorial, we will learn how to reduce the edge paint task in Nuke compositing. Let's see. As always, we are having the input in Nuke here. This time we are having multiple inputs for a comp. So first of all, I will just go into the project settings and setting the project. So it is almost done. And now we will see the input and as well as the BG. So I'm just using a merge node to merge this both. And let's see what the results. The result is a little weird because there is no alpha present in the FG. So we need to do a key light operation to get the FG here. So I'm just connecting into the source and let's key it. So I'm selecting this area for green screen separation. Yeah, we got an alpha mat here. We can use the screen gain and screen balance for getting the good result. I mean, getting the alpha very much clear. Yeah, so almost we get a nice alpha over here. Always check the gain operation while taking an alpha. I'm just shuffling the key light alpha into RGBA. Now in RGBA we have alpha. Yeah, in every channels we have alpha now. So we got an alpha for this footage. Now I'm just going to pre-multiply the FG with this alpha using copy and pre-mult node. So I'm just connecting the copy node here and now I'm just pre-multiplying here. Yeah, we can see like the copy and pre-mult done the pre-mult operation. And while merging this FG over BG, we can get this result because we produce an alpha in the FG. So, but we can see some weird green screen edges over the FG. So we are using the edge blur for clearing this green fringes from the pre-multiplied result. So using edge blur, normally edge blur do the edge blur operation, like blurring the edges. Nothing will be affected inside the footage, I mean the FG. So we are just going to see the edge properties. Here we can see the channel which the edge blur affects, and also the size which we can adjust for like blurring the edges. So we can see the filters as well and other options as well. Here we can see edge mult. This just sharpens the blur operations. And here we can see tint operation. This is really handy for like edge fix treatments and all. We can fill, I mean we can change the color where the blur operation affects actually. So here I am just adjusting the color as well as the brightness. We can adjust for getting the accurate results. So here we just reduce the green color. So using this operation we can do the edge fix treatment very easily. In some areas it will be affecting very nicely, but in some other areas like here if we are checking, yeah, the result is almost good, but this area is having some issues like the green screen is not removed completely. So I'm just using a roto node to specifically do this edge blur operation over this area, and I will do another edge blur operations for that area which need more specification. So I'm using an invert node here to get the invert mat of the hand. So I'm just, yeah, here we can see the other color operations as well as we can pick the color from the FG. So here we are getting some weird results. This is because some areas this edge blur cannot be handy. For a rough result we can do it very easily using edge blur node, and this is a default node in the Nuke itself, so we can use it very easily. So just adjust the color according to the need for us, and now the result is actually good. Only we need let's fix this. So this much results is happening in the FG. So edge blur can help us very very nicely. Now I will give you a bonus tip actually. So I'm using a blur node for blurring the mat. Okay, let's view it. Yeah, so I'm blurring the mat here. Now if we want to blur like a small level, means we can use the soften node instead of blur. This is a separate algorithm for blur itself. We can control the reach as well as size of the blur, as well as we can fix the minimum and maximum amount of blur it should affect. Yeah, this will be really handy for playing with the blur operation for small blurred areas. So this is a great option, like soften node, which is present in Nuke. Now I will show you the RGBA out here. Like I have an input here. Now I'm just going to do the blur operation as well as soften node operation in this footage. Let's see what results we get using both nodes. I'm just taking the soften node also, connecting it both. I'm just connecting and 1, 2, 3. Okay, now I'm just giving a blur of some value. Yeah, okay, see the blur operation is happening now. I'm just giving a value of 5 here. Yeah, let's see. Now if I'm going into the soften node, the blur operation is happening in some other method, like some other filter operation is happening. So if you give minute results, almost blur like it is happening, but some differences are there actually. So we can control the blur operations very well in soften node. So make use of this tutorial. Let's grow our channel in 2019 more vibrant and more informative. We are working on a platform that you can pay and learn pro level rotopaint as well as composting techniques. We already have a Patreon account. Be a part of the learning by donating so that it can really value our hard work. Follow madlookzVFX Facebook, Twitter and Instagram handles for more VFX updates and informations. Seriously guys, like, comment, subscribe madlookzVFX, share with your friends. Thank you.